Good evening and welcome, proud families and friends. On behalf of the seniors of the graduating class of 2015, thank you all for being here to honor and celebrate our success and accomplishments. I am Stephanie Brock, and I am tremendously proud to represent my classmates as the class president. Steve Jobs once said, "Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by the results of other people's thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your inner voice. And most important, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become. Everything else is secondary." I believe this quote has the utmost relevance to today's ceremony, which is the culmination of four crucial years for each senior here today. When it comes down to it, high school is about learning. Perhaps more important than any of the academic things we learned are the things high school has taught us about ourselves. See, high school is a quest, and as I have learned from a brilliant English teacher, all quests have a common end goal, to gain self-knowledge. This being said, I implore my classmates to take a moment to reflect upon the personal discoveries, ideas, characteristics, talents, and passions that they have developed over the past 4 years. The thing about growing up is that no one can tell you how to do it or how you're supposed to end up. Instead, you have to pick and choose from the experiences of each day and find your way with a moral compass you are still in the process of piecing together. As E.E. Cummings admitted, it takes courage to grow up and turn out to be who you really are. To be nobody but yourself in a world that is doing its best to make you somebody else is to fight the hardest battle you are ever going to fight. Nevertheless, here we all sit, so beautifully different and unique, each of us with our own bundle of facts about ourselves that we have worked so diligently to bind together. This wonderful summation of knowledge should serve as an instruction manual, telling us how to apply our gifts and ideas to the needs of the world around us. To summarize, sometimes a person will start a quest, but in the case of every senior here today, this quest started us. Please join me in a round of applause to celebrate the graduates sitting before you. Gets away from us, thank you to band director Mr. Craig Heidenberg, choir director Mrs. Laura Keenan, and all the musicians and vocalists for sharing their time and talents with us today. Now it is my pleasure to introduce to you the individuals sharing the stage with me. The Bay City Public School Superintendent, Mr. Doug Newcomb, and our esteemed board members, President Pauline Helmling, Treasurer Mike Wilcox, Secretary Carrie Cepeda, and trustees John Billette and Jean Rademacher, as well as Curriculum Director Adair Almack, Director of Assessment Ryan Johnson, and Transportation Director Dave Fund. The students on the stage today are the members of our 2015 Student Council. Executive Board Co-Chairs Brianna Baranek and Erica Wegner, and Executive Secretary Brianna Summers, as well as Vice President Janelle Spelt. In addition, we have valedictorian Andrew Lawrence and our selected student speaker, Andrew Schindler. Finally, we have our assistant principals of Western High School, Mr. Folsom, Mr. Thayer, and Mrs. Rosinski, along with our principal, Mrs. Cox. Mrs. Cox will begin the official send-off of the Bay City Western High School graduating class of 2015 in a few moments. At this time, however, I would like to turn the podium over to our next speaker, Mr. Doug Newcomb.
Thank you, Stephanie. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Western High School on such an important occasion. Tonight is very special, as these students that are sitting here before us have earned their high school diploma. Students, this is an important accomplishment that no one can ever take away from you. And once you walk out of this gymnasium tonight, you are going to become alumni here at Bay City Western High School with all of its long and rich traditions. Tonight also marks change and a new beginning for each of you. After the celebration has ended, you'll be starting a new phase of your lives with many different plans and paths. But at this moment, this is your day, this is your night. Each and every one of you should be proud of your achievements. All of us here are very proud of you And we want you to continue to make us proud, not only in your accomplishments, but also in how you conduct your lives. Tonight is a night for thanks. There are a lot of people here tonight, and some perhaps who could not make it here tonight, that care about you. To your parents and grandparents, your family members, your teachers, the Western staff and principals, I'd like you right now to thank all of them with a round of applause. You see, seeing you here tonight, becoming the young men and women who will be our next generation of leaders, confirms for all of them that their time and efforts to help you were important. My challenge to you is that you continue working hard and making choices in life that honor yourselves, your family, your teachers, and others, just as you have done for the diploma you are about to receive. Now, I know that you are excited about graduating, and you should be. Some of you may also be feeling a little sad and anxious because you may not see all of your family and friends as much as you have, depending on what your future plans or what the future holds for you, or whether you have a plan right at this time or not. Those feelings are all very perfectly normal, and they make us all human. Keep in mind that you are at the beginning of your adventure. You have your whole lives in front of you, where anything is possible if you believe in yourselves and you're willing to do your very best to reach your goals. The best advice that I can give you is to work hard, stay positive, and look at the future with optimism and excitement, even when things don't work out. Don't let the fear of change or something new or the unknown influence your decisions. Instead, be guided by what you want to accomplish and how you want to improve yourself and the world around you. Be humble and realize that you did not get here alone, nor will you succeed in the future alone. A good case in point is a football running back. That running back is only as good as the other players that are blocking for him. We all need each other through our lives, no matter how intelligent or skilled we are. So handle the challenges and setbacks in life with grace, with determination, with optimism, and be true to those that care about you. If you do those things, you will get through the bad times and be the success that you and we all know you can be. And you will do it with everyone's respect. Class of 2015, I wish you all the best for the future and congratulations for a job well done.
Thank you for your thoughtful words, Mr. Newcomb. That will really give us all something to think about. My name is Brianna Baranek, and I have the pleasure of introducing our 27th distinguished alumnus of Western High School. Ms. Kelly Coates is a warrior to the core and one that exudes Western pride in all that she does. As a member of Western High School's graduating class of 1979, Ms. Coates was also a member of the Esteticos chapter of National Honor Society, the school newspaper, athletics, and student council. Upon graduation, Ms. Coates started her post-secondary education at Delta College and then transferred to Central Michigan University to major in English and earn her bachelor's degree to pursue a teaching career. Once starting her teaching career, Ms. Coates completed her master's in the art of teaching from Marygrove College. Today, Ms. Coates is an English teacher at the best high school there is, your very own, Bay City Western. Many of us have had the opportunity and pleasure to have Ms. Coates as a teacher, and we couldn't be prouder to have the brilliant minds that have taught us to be honored today as our distinguished alumni. So without further ado, please welcome Ms. Kelly Coates.
It is a good day to be a Warrior. Thank you, everyone, for being a part of this terrific celebration today. Wow, a high school teacher being recognized as a distinguished alum. Incredible. I must admit, when I was notified of this prestigious honor, I immediately thought, what? Didn't anyone else get nominated? Our list of past recipients is very impressive. PhDs, successful business entrepreneurs, a television actress. My second thought was, whew, looks like the staff dodged a potentially embarrassing moment. Sometimes people get up here and kind of air their laundry. You know, something like, did you ever see that travel coffee mug that Mindy carries around? What do you think's in that? I mean, who goes around, whamma jamma, mamma jamma, have a day? Or, the only reason I came to school was to see Mrs. Welch. Is she still smoking hot? For the record, yes, she is. And Mr. Bailey? Well, I don't think I really need to go on with that one. All kidding and fun aside, I'm extremely proud to be a part of the Western family. My colleagues sitting in front of you are some of the finest people I know. They are kind, they are smart, and they are dedicated to their craft. I feel like this award validates all of us. And by us, I am including all of my teaching colleagues. My 1979 classmates, Lisa and Art Manuel and Mary Ellen Kelly, Western grads who are in education, Jill Rosinski, Gwen Kieser, Beth Jahosky, Amanda Ostrowski, Rich Searing, Heidi Schlosser, former students like Mike Rohde, Kim Hilliard, Ron Ahrens, and future teachers like Ross Corbett, Lauren Bitzer, and graduate Kelsey Haig. The pillars of Western High School are those who came before me, but created the standard of excellence that we all strive to meet. People like Tom Drummond, Bob Davidson, Mr. Fitz, Jim Reed, Mary Moskal, Dick Harmon, Charlie Schwartz, and of course, the father of Western High School, Mr. Al Bryan, whose vision, leadership, and mantra of doing what is right still resonates strongly every single day. And as I enjoy the twilight of my career, I am forever grateful for my first teachers, my parents, who showed me what it looked like to work hard and reminded my sister, Kim, and me more than once to give it our best effort every day. For Ron Mindy, my biggest cheerleader, and my school BFF, Ann Riffle, for sharing the same crazy dedication, and because both of you make my days better. Wow, that is an amazing who's who list. And lastly, I thank these young, delicious people in front of me. You make my heart smile, and you are the promise to a bright future. You make every day a happy acorn kind of day. You know, at this point, I know I'm supposed to impart some scholarly advice or worldly wisdom that I may have missed in the last 4 years. But instead, I can't resist giving you one more assignment. Write your own story. Pick up your metaphorical pen and draft your own storyline. Your story leading today is your prologue. You know that part before the novel that you always skip to save time? But today, you get to decide which characters will dominate your story, what lands you will introduce to your setting. Don't worry about erasing or deleting all the conflict. Remember, no good story exists without a twist or a complication along the way. Mostly, conflict makes a story richer. Please allow me, with a little bit of help from my friends, to suggest some chapter titles that you might want to consider. Shower the people you love with love. Never lose an opportunity to see anything beautiful. The only way to have a friend is to be a friend. There is no substitute for hard work. Extraordinary magic is woven through ordinary life. Look deep into nature, and then you will understand everything better. A little nonsense now and then is cherished by the wisest men. Dogs are not our whole life, but they do make our lives whole. Be yourself in a world that is constantly trying to make you something else. And finally, my favorite from Emerson, write it on your heart that every day is the best day in the year. Thank you. Ker he.
Thank you very much, Ms. Coates. You are truly an inspiration to all of us. On behalf of Western High, I'd like to honor you with this plaque for being our alumnus. And now, here is Erica Wagner.
Good afternoon. My name is Erica Wagner, and it is my pleasure to introduce the senior choir members, directed by Mrs. Laura Keenan. The seniors will be singing You'll Never Walk Alone, composed by Christopher Peterson. Let's welcome the seniors now.
Storm, hold your head up high, and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of a storm is a golden sky and the sweet silver song. Thank you.
Thank you, senior choir members and Mrs. Keenan. You did a wonderful job. It brought tears to my eyes. Our choir members are just another example of the impressive talent we have in our graduating class. My name is Brianna Summers, and I have the great pleasure of introducing two of our classmates who I am sure have prepared some kind, thought-provoking words for us today. First, we will hear from our valedictorian, Andrew Lawrence, who will be followed by our student selected speaker, Andrew Elijah Schindler. Please help me welcome our valedictorian, Andrew Lawrence, to the podium at this time.
Good evening, all staff, all guests, and fellow graduates. I would like to start by congratulating our Western High School class of 2015. Your academic success over the past 4 years has been outstanding. There is no doubt that this four-year journey has taught us significantly more than math and history. It has taught us lessons about ourselves and about others, ones that books cannot teach. These lessons were guided by the many important people we encountered throughout the journey. Just this year, besides teaching me how to use integral and differentiable functions, Mr. Keyser taught me the importance of a healthy breakfast to jumpstart the day. Mr. Bailey taught everyone that Mr. Bailey is always right. And Ms. Welch taught us that physics was fun with a PH. Alongside these valuable lessons, our classmates are critical to our maturation and learning. I cannot stress enough the importance of having quality friends throughout high school and throughout life. People shape experiences and help us create memories, relationships, and knowledge that will last a lifetime. Going forward, they can help us achieve each of our unique goals, dividing monumental tasks into manageable ones. In the end, they help us become better versions of ourselves. So I'd like to ask you all to remember your classmates and the times that brought us all together. From the pep rallies, to hearing about a school record being broken, to football games against our rivals, lighting up stadiums with chants from years past. We all now have greater potential than 4 years ago. We have built our repertoire with the help of our peers and educators. I'd like to thank my family for being loving, caring people I can look up to and providing me with moral and academic support throughout my life, which is essential to where I am today. I'd like to thank the staff for making the high school experience a memorable one and working tirelessly to accommodate the group of nearly 300 students that stand before you today. You raised a good-looking group. And I'd like to thank my fellow graduates for creating an atmosphere in which we could all grow, bond, and look back on high school as an influential page and the next chapter of our lives. But I think the important underlying lesson we can take away from all this is that we need each other to succeed. And as we look to the future, and some of us go away to college, start a career, or whatever else our futures may hold, we are bound to meet new people who will help us restart the process. On a final note, I'd like to leave you with a quote from Alexander Graham Bell. He stated, "Great discoveries and improvements invariably involve the cooperation of many minds." I may be given credit for having blazed the trail, but when I look at the subsequent developments, I feel the credit is due to others rather than to myself. Thank you.
Thank you, Andrew. Now, please join me in welcoming Mr. Andrew Elijah Schindler, our student selected speaker, to the podium.
Four score and 7 years ago. Oh wait, sorry, that's not right. Ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your. No, that's not right either. Okay. This day is called the Feast of Crispin. That's Shakespeare. or give me liberty, or give me, that's not it, okay. All right, I've had enough of famous speeches. I'm just going to tell a familiar story. And it's familiar because this story belongs to the class of 2015. More than 10 years ago, we started preschool and kindergarten, and unless you had superpowers, you were scared. And then 5 years later, when we finished elementary school, we were excited because back then, school was easy. Like, really easy. And then 3 years after that, when we finally finished eighth grade, we were excited because middle school is middle school. Yeah. But we were scared because we were going to high school, a place where childhood dreams go and are never seen again. Luckily, our dreams only grew up. When we made it to high school, we were but stupid freshmen, taking our first careful steps down the hallowed halls of Western. We looked at the upperclassmen and saw what we wished we could be. We looked up at the stars and said, gee, that doesn't look too high. Then we became sophomores, which is a fancy word for not freshmen. That was when we made many friendships, many of which have lasted to this day. Sophomore year was the year of discovery. That was when we found out what we wanted to do in school. We chose classes and activities that gave us the drive we needed to succeed. Being a junior is cool too, because all the work we did started to pay off, and we were upperclassmen, which was awesome. Junior year was full of hard work and reward. We were old enough to be leaders, and when we chose to act, we changed things for the better. This last year, we were finally seniors. We spent our last months getting ready for the future, going to assemblies, and waiting for this year to be done. But now that it's here, it might feel like it came too soon. That's the problem with being so close to the end of school. We're so excited for the future that we forget the wonderfully spectacular amazingness that each of us accomplished by ourselves and with others. We all spent hours practicing to become better. We trained for months to become the fastest or the strongest. Some dedicated themselves to art, spending countless more hours creating or expressing something new. Still, others learned valuable career skills that they can use to support themselves in the future. We accomplished so much. Just think, in a little while, we're gonna walk out of here with our PhDs, or public high school diplomas. They're pretty much the same thing, I've been told. So, in honor of our collective accomplishments, I'd like to give everyone of the class of 2015 an air high five. Now, don't get me wrong. Not all these years were easy. Sometimes we tried our hardest and failed regardless, but all of us kept moving forward. That is what we are being recognized for today. I ask you to keep on challenging yourselves because, as Lord Alfred Tennyson almost said, "'Tis better to have lived and lost than never to have lived at all." That's exactly what he sounds like, by the way. Today, as high school officially ends, we are scared, excited, and relieved. Scared because change is scary. Excited because it's summer. And relieved because John Glenn let their seniors out sometime in April. I mean, come on. All right, I'm gonna let you go now, but not before I say, my name is Andrew Elijah Schindler, and we are the class of 2015!
Speakers, another round of applause. They did a great job. My name is Janelle Speltz, and I had the privilege of serving as vice president of this amazing senior class. I will definitely miss it, and I wish you all the best. At this time, on behalf of the graduating class of 2015, I would like to welcome our principal, Mrs. Cox, to the podium.
Good evening. Once again, welcome parents, family, and friends of the graduating class of 2015. Today is an exciting day for all of us, myself included. However, it's hard for me to describe the emotions this ceremony brings. Undoubtedly, I am so proud of each of you, and at the same time sad, because I know my time with you is coming to an end. I know I've said it before, but I want to convey how grateful I am to share in these memories. Before I address these wonderful people in front of me, I'd also like to take a moment to thank Superintendent Newcomb, board members Mrs. Hemling, Mrs. Zapata, Mr. Billette, and Mr. Rademacher, along with central office colleagues Mr. Amok, Mr. Johnson, and Mr. Funt, for their support throughout the year and for being here today to share in our celebration. I'd also like to thank all the people who have helped organize and contribute to our ceremony today. Mr. Harmon and Mrs. Welch, the maintenance staff, Kite's Greenhouse for the beautiful flowers and plants, and of course, Mr. Mindy for arranging them just right. And another special thanks to the Western High School Band and Choir for their amazing performances today. Finally, students, take a look around you today and help me thank all the wonderful teachers and family members who have guided and encouraged you over the last 4 years of your education. My seniors. I'm gonna try really hard not to get all emotional, but I am really not making any promises. It may have not seemed like it to you, but I can hardly believe our final year together is coming to a close. I've been thinking about what I want to talk to you about for quite some time, but it was really hard for me to make a decision about what I really wanted to say. So in preparation for today, I started looking at other graduation speeches. I mean, come on, some of these speeches end up on national TV because they are so good. So I thought, why not look to the experts and the advice they have given over the years? So I did what we all do, and I went to Google. I watched Michelle Obama advise graduates of Tuskegee University to vote, 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 and I thought, nope, not worried about that with my seniors. I know their voices will be heard, just like they did when they weren't so happy about the changes made to number one fan. Then, I watched a clip of Jon Bon Jovi singing to the graduates from Rutgers University about making memories, taking pictures, and enjoying the moment. Don't worry, I'm not going to sing because we all know I'm not musically inclined. But again, I thought, nope, my seniors know how to do that too. When I returned from China, it was clear a lot of memories were made based on the amount of pictures on Twitter with the hashtag, I don't know, something about loving your administrators. I also heard about some cute Halloween outfits. So I'm confident you made lots of memories. You definitely let the Western world know you were here by everything you did. Finally, I watched a few other principals give their high school commencement speeches, and I heard a common theme. Telling students to set your goals high, reach for the stars, you can be anything. I heard you could be the next Bill Gates, or the next Derek Jeter, or the next Jennifer Lawrence, or even the next Mr. Bailey. And I thought, that's it. I need to share the best advice I have ever heard, and it has served me well for many years. And it just so happens, I heard it from my mom. It's simple as this. Don't try to be somebody else. Don't try to be the next Bill Gates or the next Derek Jeter. Be the best you there is. Don't stress yourself out trying to be something you're not. You will never go wrong if you just be the best version of yourself. And while I'm at it, a little second piece of advice. When you are seeking out advice and guidance, you don't have to go to Google or YouTube. Just take a look around. When advice comes from a source of love, it can't be wrong. So take the time to really listen to your parents and adults around you. They are wise people, and their advice comes from a place of love, just like mine today. So there it is, my two pieces of advice. Be the best you there is, and take the time to really listen to your mom and dad and the adults in your lives. On behalf of the entire staff at Western High School, I want to thank you for your hard work, your enthusiasm, and your respect you have shown during your time here. You have definitely left your mark on us, and I hope we have left our mark on you. Congratulations, class of 2015. Well done. President Pauline Hemling, it gives me great pleasure to present to you the 42nd graduating class of Western High School, the class of 2015.
A graduation ceremony is an event where the commencement speaker tells hundreds of students dressed in identical caps and gowns that individuality is the key to success. Today is your success story. After many years of hard work and dedication, you are graduating. I hope graduating from high school is just one of your many success stories. I also hope that as you grow, the meaning of success will take on different definitions. My wish for you is that success means finding something you are passionate about and pursuing it with all your heart. That success means helping others along the way and doing the right thing even when nobody's watching. I hope success means living a life with compassion, integrity, and never settling. I hope success also means making this world a better place because of what you have done and who you have become. Mrs. Cox, we have reviewed the records and transcripts of the students today and have found them to be in order. It is with honor and pride that I certify and accept this Western High School graduating class of 2015.
Dante Ballard. Joseph Bolette. Madison Brownell. Paul Brayman. Allison Casey.
Olivia Ferguson.
Aaron Fritz. Autumn Gibney. Dakota Garcia. Kara Gray. Allison Gower. Noah Gerhardt. Laura Geneseo. Russell Frito. Tracy Gray. Tracy Gary. Clay Freisinger. Alexis Finn. David Fagan. Rachel Falado. Travis Boston. Seth Gosselin. Emily Gunther. Joshua Gresham. Kristen Harmon. Tristan Hammond.
Bailey Henning. Stephen Helm. Lillian Hendrick. Robert Heritor. Katerina Hilden. Alice Hoffman. Zachary Hobgood. Megan Peacock. Travis Haverkamp. Victoria Hebert. Andrew Hartfelder. Alexandria Harvey. Jared Grasso. Kelsey Haig. Nicholas Gonzalez. Justin Holloway. Autumn Holschlag. Quinton Jezuski. August James. Alec Justin. Sabrina Jeffrey. Harry Jin-ho Kim. Shayla Krieger. Blake Koju. Brittany Keeney. Anna Keeney. Dylan Kinnair. Paige Kegley. Jared Kloa. Samantha Kiefer. Zachary Kaczynski. Caitlin Jammer. Nicholas Jacobs. Michaela Homstead. Austin Huff. Austin Kruger. Madison Laney. Seth LaCourse. Jamie Lehman. Austin Lalonde. Amber Lopez. Jared Leonard. Madison Mapes. Noah Micah.
Cody Laterno. Riley Martin. Madison Marcinian. Samantha Lukens. Will Loftner. Sydney Leinberger. Dustin LaFrambois. Danielle Larson. Avery Kukla. Haley Kukla. CJ Kraus. Hayden Lewicki. Paige McKenzie. Jacob Littlejohn. Hannah Merritt. Cody Losey. Kayla Morse.
Martin. Kelsey Nickel. Samuel Mahalik. Abigail Noack. Madison Nielsen. Andrew Miller. Abigail Nephew. Troy McKee. Alicia Nelson. Alex Ludwig. Blair Miller. Darian Lone. Tegan McDonald. Ryan Linderman. Ryan Moon. Mallory Ozarzek. Andrew Moulton. Casey Patterson. Austin Myers. Tangela Pryor. Cody Lee Oaks. Chloe Reardon. Chase Packard. Shelby Reese. Laura Rubzegger. James Petrimo. Emily Reinhardt.
Jonah O'Loughlin. Kayla Polsonelli. Gabriel Lebronza. Bailey Fowler. Alexander Mudd. Celestia Parks. David Mowbray. Bailey O'Farrell. Emily Russell. Trenton Passion. Alicia Sanders. Evan Prawl. Bethany Scanlon. Eli Rotz. Brooke Strawn. Ryan Ralph. Heather Stoller. Taylor Thomas Ozarza. Anthony Robbins. Devin Schneider. Austin Ron. Caitlin Schatzer. Cody Provo. Courtney Sacco. Drew Pisha. Destiny Reluski. Dean Ferris. Nathan Robbins. Emily Swatala. Keith Rodriguez. Grace Trombley. Caitlin Waterman. Jonathan Smurden. Lauren Wozni. Tyler Shorkey. Shaylin Worsinski. Shane Seguin. Greg Sola. Nicole Wilson. Ryan Sullivan. Madeline Wingard. Mitchell Searing.
Shannon Winters.